Okay, so I tend to get some questions about how I like plan out my days when I'm working from home. Like, to be honest, this is kind of the way I've always done it, even when people weren't like just like working from home. Because obviously like I shoot all my content at home. So I've kind of always tried to plan my days out like this. I suppose the main difference would be I have a lot more of a focus now on like ways to step away from work while I'm at home, because obviously I used to be able to kind of, you know, go out and do things, and a lot of my work as well would be maybe I was going out and filming with somebody or on location for something or an event or things like that. So that is where I've kind of changed up how I lay out my day. So I have two things that really get me through my day. So I have like my monthly planner, and then I also have the head plan. This monthly planner is just one from Primark, but I actually, my little sister is currently making me, she's so good, like a little flip one. So it will like sit on my desk like that, and I'll be able to like flip it open, and it's gonna have like really big sections for me to write in, because I just need things. I'll show you why I need something a bit bigger, but this is a lovely planner though. Just got it in Primark. Okay, so the way that I split up my day is basically I have my morning routine, which you're probably familiar with because I post about it a good bit on my Instagram. So I'll have my morning routine, and I see that as like one block of the day. When that goes off smoothly, I feel like the whole rest of the day is like onto such a good flow. And then I will have my morning split up by lunchtime, afternoon work, dinner, evening for enjoyment. So usually what I'll do is my morning starts at about 5:30. I'll get up, do a little bit of reading, and then go out and walk from 6 till about 6:45. Come home, I'll do a bit of spinning, a little bit of a workout, and then have my breakfast with John. And then I usually try and start work then by 9 o'clock. So I will split it up into between like 9 and 1 is the first half of my work day. And then I'll take a break from about 1 till 2:30, and then 2:30 until about 5-ish will be the second half of my work day. So I kind of look at it as those two blocks. So I've got that, the first half of my work day and second half of my work day, and I split those up into maybe like two separate parts each. So I've got kind of like four work parts going on, if that makes sense. And I just will make sure that I do that usually at the start of the week. I can't really plan any more in advance than that, because I work with brands, and sometimes things change, and sometimes, you know, you're maybe like, you know, if say I'm shooting with a fashion brand this week, and I was supposed to have the content sent and everything for approval over the last day, but obviously there's loads of delays going on with shipping and everything right now, and the product hasn't arrived yet, so I haven't been able to shoot it. So there's only so much that so far in advance that I can really split things up, but that's just for my work. So for your work, it might be a little bit more predictable. But basically, I will go like, say, well, at the start of each week, I will write down how I'm going to break up my weekday. Okay, so I will have at the top of the page all the things that I want to get done for that week, and that are like my main priorities. And then I will have each day just written out as a little to-do list, pretty much. So say I have like all the times written down here, and then I'll have all the little things that I want to get done. And I list them as small as being like, from 6 till 7, I'm on my walk, or like from 9 to 11, I'm doing emails. From 11 till 1, I'm filming an IGTV and posting a post. Then like I do my lunch break, and then from 2:30 till 3:30, I'm doing a story tutorial. From 3:30 till 5:00, I am editing a video for work. And then I'm gonna have my dinner at 5 o'clock and relax the rest of the evening. So just something as simple as that, but being able to visually see it on a page, and writing it down kind of just gets it into your head. And I'm just such a visual person that, like, from just seeing it, it just keeps me on track for the day. And I think once you have something written down to do it, it kind of pushes you to do it that little bit more. Then I will try and write in my head plan every morning as well. These are just the most beautiful books. I love them. And I think you can get them online, and you can also get them in Arnott's and Brian Thomas. So my goal for one of my goals for this year was to try and write in this more, because I wasn't great last year. And this is just kind of to keep your head on track, really. So, like, it'll ask you questions like, what are your main goals of the day? And it's more like for your head. So, like, although filming this one piece of content that I definitely wanted to have done, that's more of a work thing. But for me, it would actually cause me less stress if I got that extra piece of work done, so I could relax tomorrow. And because it's Friday and I want to finish up a little bit earlier. And then another thing is, like, I want to relax and find a new series. My top three tasks of the day, like, one of them is, like, just get some fresh air and drink 3 liters of water, hit my step. So just little things as small as that. And then, like, you know, what are your self-care and wellness actions? I'm going to find a new Netflix series tonight. And then your productivity reward today. And I have chocolate with a little smiley face because I love chocolate. So they're kind of like my things that I'll write in here. So I write in that every morning. And just having them written down really, really helps me. So yeah, that's kind of how I split up my day and keep me on track. So hopefully that's a little bit helpful. Hey, you helping me with my workout? Hello? You helping me? Currently about to make myself a little snack after lunch. I was just out filming or shooting a picture for this outfit that I have on. Can't really see, but it's so fab. It's from Karen Millen. So I had to get out and get a little photo of that, and it turned out really well, so I'm happy. Now I'm gonna have one of my favorites, these little naked bars, and I pop it in the microwave for like 30 seconds. It's so delicious. And I'm making a little cup of peppermint in one of my favorite mugs. I've done a little change in a different outfit, and we are having date night. So we've got some nice food, we're gonna make some gin and tonics, and bellissimo. Okay, I didn't vlog over the weekend, but I wanted to show. I wrapped my hair. I just gave it a little quick blow dry, and I wrapped it up like this. A couple bits have fallen out, but I'm not going to be able to sleep with it in because it's giving me a bit of a headache. So I'm going to take it out now, and let's see what the result is. So there's a bit of a better look. Okay, so this side has like one curl in the front, kink in the back, and then this side's completely straight with like a kink in one or two pieces. So yeah, we won't be doing that again. Hello, okay, I stabbed myself in the hand today. Oh god, was cutting my avocado, you know, like the little thing that's in the center of the avocado, and I went to like put my knife through to kind of scoop it out, and the avocado was at the perfect consistency. Delicious, absolutely delicious. But I didn't realize it was so perfect and that the knife would just go straight through the avocado. So there was like, stab myself and there's an avocado in between. So it's like the knife, the avocado, and then the stabbing of the hand. And I had to pull it out. Oh, Bonnie. What have you done? Anyway, managed to sort myself out. So I just got a jack from another stories, which I really want to try on. So I'm going to try that on and give you a look at it. And then I will finish up. Okay, so this is the blazer. It's quite oversized. I went for the smallest size they had. I think this is like a 32. And it's got like a button on the inside and then a button to close it here. Here's a kind of a better look at the texture of it. So I'm actually currently just about to start filming an assumptions video for my YouTube channel, which will be up. I'm actually not sure when I'm going to upload it, so we shall see. I said that I come and wrap up my vlog. So I have on that new blazer that I was giving you a little look at from another story. So it is oversized. So if anybody is getting it, just make sure that, like, I'd even maybe size down. So I went for the 32 in it, and it's still really, really big. I'm going to finish up the vlog here. A few days in the life with Bonnie. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did like this video, make sure you subscribe to my channel so you see when my next videos are going up. I'm going to have my assumptions video coming up soon, and I'm also going to be doing a get ready with me. Make sure you like this video, and I will be replying to all the comments down below. So if you have any questions, just comment, let me know what you thought of this video, and until next time.